Hi there, my name is Kriyanche, and welcome to episode 5 of my Logistics Pipes tutorial series for Minecraft 1.7.10. So last episode, we talked about how you are able to auto-craft and auto-process materials using your Logistics Pipes network, and today we will be talking about how you are able to transfer power through those same Logistics Pipes so you don't need to run energy cables like I did last episode. So let's get started. To get started, you will need a couple of things. First of all is the Logistics RF Power Provider. The Logistics RF Power Provider is the block that actually pumps in power into the Logistics Pipe network. So as you can see right here, I hooked it up to the other power source that I created a long time ago to demonstrate to you guys that this thing will eventually send its power through these pipes to the actual machines that you want to power. Don't confuse this with the Logistics Power Junction, as the Power Junction only powers the actual pipes, so you're able to send items through, as the RF Power Provider only powers third-party machines and not things that are actually connected to the network, so keep that in mind. The next up is the actual Power Supplier Upgrades. You can either use the Thermal Expansion Power Supplier Upgrades or the Industrial Craft one. As I do not have Industrial Craft 2 installed, I will be sticking with the Thermal Expansion one for this tutorial, as this is also one of the easiest to use as you don't have to deal with the separate voltages. And then finally, you will need a handful or two of power transportation upgrades, as these things are something you will need quite a lot, as you will have to put them on every intersection of your pipes. So let's show you how to actually do this. So as I pretty much explained in the first episode of this series, for a couple of things you will need the Logistics Pipe Controller. This is one of those things. Because if you right-click on a basic logistics pipes or higher, so anything that's not an unrouted transport pipe, pretty much, you'll be able to see this little menu. These things are not really necessary, so don't bother using them for now. But what you will need is the actual upgrades. So as I explained, you will need either the Thermal Expansion Power Supply upgrade or the Power Transportation upgrade. Pretty much what those two upgrades mean is the power transportation upgrade means that you will have to put it on every intersection where you want to be able to transfer power. And the thermal expansion power supplier upgrade is the actual upgrade you put in to the exact location of the machine that you want to power. You might think this is a little bit confusing, but don't worry, I will show you the actual practical example of this. So what I did is I put a power transportation upgrade in here, and a thermal expansion power supplier upgrade in here. And if I would get myself a furnace, let me quickly copy this one over, and put it right next to here, the pipe with the actual supplier upgrade on it, you will see in a second, it's already full. I need to get myself an empty one. That would also help, because it's no use sending power over once it's actually already full. There we go, this should be empty. As you can see, if I put it down, you'll see this red beam being sent from this Logistics RF Power Provider over to this one, and this redstone furnace will fill up. Again, at a pretty decent speed, so that's pretty useful. But the thing is, it is kind of expensive if you want to run it over a very long distance. But of course, it does save you a bit of space, as you don't need to run redstone energy flux ducts or any other material over. So yeah, that's pretty cool. So let's say I want to power those actual machines instead of using those cables. So what I can do is quickly break these, and let's get rid of this power line, as it will be no longer needed. Pretty much what you need to do is on every intersection with a basic logistics pipe or higher, so again, not an unrouted pipe, that wouldn't be necessary, but any other type of pipe, you will need to put in the power transportation upgrades. This is a little bit different than how the normal item sending part goes, as you only need to put basic logistics pipes, for example, at the end of this. But you need to put the actual power transportation upgrades in every pipe that's in its way. So right there goes one, right there. Keep in mind, you can also just right click on the pipe with them, so that saves you a bit of time. So I need to put one right there, not right there. But I do have to put them on every one that it has to go through. Oh, not right there, though. Keep in mind. Because this is the actual thing that I want to power. So right here, I put the thermal expansion upgrade. And now, if I try to smelt something in here, Let's get some cobblestone out. It should, in theory, if I didn't miss anything, should start powering. But apparently I missed something. What did I miss? Is there some other pipe in here that I've missed? Oh wait, no. Oops, derp. You also have to make sure that you actually put basic pipes on every at every corner where it normally wouldn't be necessary, as power cannot cross corners without actually having a pipe right there. So let me put this right there. A basic pipe, that is. A little fence on here, so I got that marked for myself. And get myself the power transportation upgrade. And now what you can see is that the power is flowing from there to this corner, through there, right here, through all of these other pipes into this redstone furnace. So now this thing is being powered directly through this logistics pipe network without having you to run any extra cables. Pretty useful if you ask me. Of course, we can add some more machines if we want, for example, this other redstone furnace, like so, and get another stack of cobblestone, smelt it up. And as you can see, it will flow through this just as well. So pretty much these thermal expansion power supply upgrades function the same way as the actual power transportation upgrades. But the power transportation upgrades are a lot cheaper as they don't actually allow you to power anything by itself. Pretty useful though. So yes, that is pretty much the main idea of how to transfer power using logistics pipes. So I definitely hope you guys found this very educational. If you have, feel free to let me know down in the comment section below. And also, if you have any suggestions on what you would like to see built in a logistics pipe setup, let me know down in the comment section below and I will be sure to get back to it as soon as possible. So for next episode, I will be working on how you can implement storage wars into the logistics pipe network, just to make it a little bit easier for yourself to actually store stuff without having to have 30 different drawers with 30 different chassis pipes, but only one chassis pipe connected to 30 different storages, for example. So thanks for watching, please leave a rating, and I hope to see you guys all next time. Take care, folks.